The RIT Sports Network proudly welcomes you to the Gene Policini Center on the campus of the Rochester Institute of Technology and home of the Tigers. Tonight, it's the final game of this two-game Atlantic Hockey America series between Robert Morris and RIT. Last night, Matthew Wild recorded his 13th point of the season in just his 10th game. The sophomore from Mississauga, Ontario, will look to flip the script and help the Tigers end their eight-game winless streak here tonight. Good evening, happy holidays, and welcome to RIT Hockey Pregame Live here on the RIT Sports Network. Well, following Tuesday night's loss to Canisius that dropped the Tigers to 3-13-1 on the season, RIT head coach Wayne Wilson said, "This is what we are, and we're not good right now." Highlights from last night, Robert Morris and RIT, game one of this series at the Policini. First period, RMU on the power play. Trent Burnham playing the puck behind the net and can't get back in position in time, and the Colonials make him pay with the goal as Cameron Garvey gets his third of the year. 1-0 RMU. After a cross-checking penalty on Xavier Lapointe, RMU is second opportunity on the power play of the night, and Walter Zacher scores. 2-0 Colonials after one. Second period, just over 12 minutes ago, Colonials center the puck, and it's Zacher again, his second of the night, team leading 9th of the year. 3-0 Colonials. Just over 4 minutes remaining in the second, Tigers finally catch a break thanks to some hard work, forcing the turnover, and Matthew Wild puts it by Croy Kokendorfer, his 7th of the season. Tigers down 3-1 after two. Third period, trouble again for RIT. They turn it over in the neutral zone. Tanner Klimke beats Trent Burnham with the wrister and just 2:06 into the third. Oh, the Tigers were down 3 again. They were down 4 with over 11 minutes to go, but on the power play, persistence paying off for Tyler Fukakusa down low as he sticks it in, his 5th goal of the year. RIT down 3. Then just over 6 minutes to play, Doug Scott, the senior from North Vancouver, his 50th career game, his first career goal. Tigers back within two, but RMU would seal it with under 2 minutes to go as Trent Wilson, the trailer on the play here, is going to get the empty netter. Colonials would tack on another as they snap an 8-game losing streak. They beat RIT last night by a final of 7-3. The difference last night was special teams as the Colonials went 3-for-4 on the man advantage while killing 5-of-6 Tiger power play opportunities. Matthew Wild's 7th goal of the season ties in with Simon Isabel for the team lead. And in addition to Doug Scott getting his first career goal, first-year defenseman Ryan Williams picked up his first career point with an assist on that goal. Congratulations to both of them. As always, we have both sides of the ice covered for you. We begin with RIT and head coach Wayne Wilson, who's with our John DiTullio. Johnny?
All right, Kevin, thanks so much. Really the story last night in special teams, Wayne, when looking back on the tape, something they were doing better, or is it just something that you guys just need to button up a little bit?
Well, their power play, they never really got set up and really moved around for a goal. It was just our puck management. We had the situation behind the net. Just try to take a guy one-on-one when we're shorthanded, turn it over, up the ice they come. So it was more of those type of, I mean, 2 goals off the rush and a misplay behind our net. But from that standpoint, power play, I liked our puck movement. We could have easily had more goals, but we didn't. So to me, it wasn't a special teams problem for us, a puck management problem just in general, never mind shorthanded. I mean, one shorthanded, we failed to clear, I think it was 3 or 4 times on one thing. So for us, puck management's got to be much, much better, and if we want to prevent goals being scored against us.
Is it less about like moving people around, changing lines, or just getting down to playing RIT hockey?
Yeah, so it's not individuals, one individual not doing the job. It's collective, you know, things. So we're tweaking some things, but that's not going to be the thing that changes around. Just our mindset's got to change here, and we've just got to be flat out better.
You know, scoring fast or scoring first, how important is that in tonight's game?
Well, it's in every game, I think. But with our mental makeup right now, scoring first is it becomes a little bit bigger. But you can't stress that too much, because all of a sudden, if you don't score, what does that mean on the flip side? So we've just got to be consistent from start to finish more than anything else. And, we got to attack the game and not play on our heels.
What do you want to see from Ethan David, who will start tonight between the pipes?
Well, Ethan's had some good outings for us, so we wanted to see a good competitive start. We've got to limit their chances as well, and that's not on Ethan, but we can't give up great A opportunities like we have, and so he's got to plug the hole when we make a mistake, and we've got to carry the play and be better defensively.
Last conference game of the calendar year, added importance to get 3 points tonight, Wayne?
Well, I'd rather win that last game before break and feel good about it, that's for sure. So every game's important for us right now, and this is the next game, and it's the last game before break. So, yeah, we want to play well in this game.
All right, all the best. You know, RIT win coupled with a Penn State win, that would be a great weekend for us, buddy.
We'd both be happy.
Right?
Yeah.
That's head coach Wayne Wilson here with the RIT Tigers for a preview of RMU. Here's Gene Battaglia. Gino?
All right, thanks, John. Here with head coach Derek Schooley. Congratulations on the win last night and the power play going 3-for-4 last night. What was working for you there?
Well, I thought we did a good job attacking off the rush. And obviously, when you got some skilled players, you can make offensive plays. And I thought our guys did a really good job of attacking the net. And, you know, you look at goals by Zacher, and then Garvey gets the one on the turnover. And then Dielstra just a long, good pass by Luke Van Wy. And we attacked off the rush and created some chances.
What did it say, though? You come out, it's 3-1. You're thinking RIT is going to get a rush. That goal to start out the third, how big was that?
Well, that was really big. We wanted to get the first and extend the lead, and we kept doing that all night. We gave them a little hope with some needless penalties by us and put us down 5-on-3, which then led to a little spurt by them, but we settled back into the game, and obviously to get the two late goals was big for us.
How big would this be to get a 6-point weekend? I'm sure you don't want to leave any meat on the bone here, Coach.
No, we've got to be greedy, and it's about going out and get points and trying to continue to climb up the standings. We haven't played a lot of games, so the ability to start climbing the standings with a lot of games in hand is big for us. And, you know, when I was watching your broadcast on Tuesday, you guys were talking about 9-point weekend. Now it's on the other foot. So, you know what, sometimes you guys got to eat your words, too.
Fair enough.
I pay attention to what's going on.
Yeah, well, listen, I thank you for watching RIT Sports Zone. Derek, thanks so much.
No, thank you, guys.
Kevin, we got a viewer here from Pittsburgh.
Yeah, we appreciate him watching, and we'll see what happens here tonight. The 9-point weekend, definitely not in the cards for the Tigers this weekend. Hopefully they can get 3, though. Meanwhile, on the men's side of Atlantic Hockey America, today's game between AIC and Holy Cross was postponed. Yellow Jackets didn't have a goalie. AIC head coach Eric Lang saying on X, all 3 are injured. Sacred Heart goes for the sweep at Canisius at Harbor Center in Buffalo. Bentley will look to do the same against Mercyhurst, while after losing in overtime last night, Air Force goes for the split with Niagara. Faceoff 7:05 Eastern tonight. Well, still to come on Pregame Live, the RIT women's hockey team look to break out the brooms this afternoon against visiting Lindenwood. Highlights are on the way. Plus, he's been a fixture at Ritter Arena and the Policini Center for over 4 decades. Coming up, we'll tell you how the RIT community is rallying behind one of its own. But first, Tyler Fukakusa extended his team best 7-game point streak last night. The sophomore from Mississauga, Ontario, will join our Kim Coffee live next as our coverage rolls on. From the Gene Policini Center, it's RIT and Robert Morris at 5:05. This is Pregame Live on the RIT Sports Network. Here on Pregame Live, it's Kids Day here at the Coliseum. Plus, the annual Skate with the Tigers event comes up post-game, hopefully following a Tiger victory. That would end a 4-game losing streak. Those kids looking good here tonight. Hey, in the net for Robert Morris tonight will once again be number 1, Croy Kokendorfer. The freshman from St. Paul, Minnesota, earned his 5th win of the season last night while stopping 28 shots for the Colonials. For RIT, as we mentioned earlier, it will be number 40, Ethan David. The first year will make just his 2nd start of the season and his 1st at home. The Vancouver native lost at New Hampshire last weekend. Ethan David is 0-1 on the year with a 4.02 goals against. Well, sophomore Tyler Fukakusa, he is having a super sophomore season, centering RIT's top line. Fukakusa, he leads the Tigers with 20 points on 5 goals and 15 assists. Also leading Atlantic Hockey America as well. He's just off the ice from warm-ups, and he's standing by live now with our Kim Coffey. Kim?
Tyler, a little bit of a rough start for you guys yesterday. Got down early, had to play catch-up from there. What do you have to do to get out to establish the pace up front, be the first to score?
Yeah, I think we got to simplify our game a little bit and make sure that we get the first goal. Feel like a lot of the times during the season we've fallen behind early, and first goal tonight would be huge.
I mean, despite the loss, you and your line mates have been big contributors offensively. What's been clicking for you guys so far this season?
Yeah, I think we've just been working hard, and pucks have been bouncing our way. We just need to do more of that tonight and hopefully get a couple.
I want you to fill in the blank for me. The key to beating Robert Morris tonight is?
I think puck management. Puck management and defending our net, that'll help us win.
Tyler, thanks so much, and good luck tonight.
Thanks.
Kevin?
All right, Kim, thank you so much. Meanwhile, the RIT women's hockey team is also in town this weekend for a big Atlantic Hockey America series. Today, the Tigers look to make it a six-point weekend with a sweep of Lindenwood. We have the highlights from earlier today. Tigers won yesterday 9-4. Lindenwood responded early today, already up 1-0 in the second. And on the power play, and it's Quinn McLaren with the goal. The Lions up 2-0. Uh-oh. But that didn't last, because just 21 seconds later, RIT would get on the board thanks to Brack Kelly, her second goal this weekend and fifth on the season. Tigers back within one. Just over 6 minutes to play. Tigers, the shot, no. The rebound in front. Yes, Addie Alvarez pokes it in, her sixth of the year, to tie us at two. Then RIT on the power play late in the second period. A big season for Emma Pickering, and it continues. She gives RIT the lead. She would tack on another one in the third, as RIT scores four unanswered and completes the sweep of Lindenwood today by a final of 4-2. So the Tigers have now won two in a row and pick up a big 6 points in the conference standings. It's their first sweep of an AHA series since beating Penn State all the way back in 2020. Happy to be joined now by senior forward Jordan Bear. Jordan, welcome. First off, how gratifying is it for you and your teammates to take care of business this weekend with those two big conference victories?
It was a big, we needed those wins to be top third going out of the season. Our coach came in the dressing room and said, like, these games are, like, mandatory. We have to win. We have to battle. We have to play our systems and stuff like that. So, yeah, it does feel great, and the girls are happy in the dressing room after the day.
Yeah, there's a long way to go, but looking right now at the standings, I know it's early, but you sit only 6 points behind first place Penn State, the defending conference champions. You'll face them down in Happy Valley in January. Feeling like this team can contend for a conference title this year, the way you've performed so far here?
Oh, pardon me.
Do you feel like this team can contend this year for a conference title, the way you've performed so far this year?
Oh, yeah. Like, all the girls want it so much. All the 13 seniors, I think, really want that under our belt. Our freshmen have been contributing nonstop. So, like, I think we have a good enough team to beat Penn State.
Yeah, Jordan, the past few years, you touched on a little bit there. Scoring was difficult for this team. As you know, you were here being a senior. Not this year.
No.
All four lines are producing. How has that helped all of you play maybe a little looser, a little more freely this season?
I feel like we've all gained chemistry with each other. Like, our coach is keeping the lines the same, or, like, leaving a center and a winger the same, and it's helping us grow chemistry to get those pucks in the net, which we really need.
Absolutely, and how about your performance? Four goals in the last three games, including, congratulations, your first career hat trick yesterday. After all those years of playing hockey, how did that feel?
You know, honestly, I worked so hard to get the hat trick, and honestly, deep down, it felt exciting. And I mean, I didn't look excited, but, like, deep down, I was trying to keep it composed and not act all excited. But yeah, it felt really great, and my parents really were happy with that.
That's fantastic. Everybody was exciting, including us. We're happy for you.
Thank you.
Of luck, hey, on your finals. Happy holidays to you. And of course, we'll see you and your Tiger teammates back here on New Year's Eve for a 2:00 game against 7th-ranked Cornell. Best of luck to you.
Thanks
so much, Jordan Bear. Appreciate your time here on Pre-Game Live. Elsewhere in the women's Atlantic Hockey America action, Penn State still unbeaten in conference play. They sweep Mercyhurst 3-2. Syracuse leading Robert Morris 3-1. That in the third down in the Q's. Well, still to come on Pre-Game Live, if you're just joining us, we'll show you how Robert Morris took game one of this series last night. Plus, John and Gene will join us to share who they think we should be keeping an eye on here tonight in the rematch. That and more straight ahead on your home for Tiger Hockey. You're watching Pre-Game Live on the RIT Sports Network.
Get around the defenseman. Craig able to break it up. Robert Morris converting on the first power play, and another one!
Wow!
Walter Zacher, 24, And Robert Morris leading now 2-0. Wild getting bumped off the puck. Good chance here for the Tigers, but no. But then tipped away. Wild scores! The Tigers get a bounce, and Matthew Wild makes it 3-1. Klimke was in a good spot there. This line had all sorts of issues here. It's still not over. Ahead that goes Klimke. Klimke fires and scores. Look at this. 4-1 as the Tigers, all sorts of issues getting it out of their own end.
It's just the same old story.
Scott jumping in. Scott fires and scores. Doug Scott. Number 25 for the Tigers. How about that? His first collegiate goal makes it 5-3.
You're right back in it.
And here's an opportunity for Robert Morris to seal it. It's Zacher. Zacher going in for the hat trick. No, he's denied. Dimitri Mikrogiannakis. But then it's put back.
Yep. Trailing the play.
And the comeback attempt for the RIT Tigers will end right there.
It's not going to happen tonight.
Yeah, it did not happen as Robert Morris, after losing 6 games in this building a year ago and 8 in a row overall, they finally beat the Tigers last night. Final score 7-3 if you're just joining us. As we welcome in John and Gene, who will once again be on the call here tonight. Guys, in addition to some reoccurring Tiger miscues that cost RIT, special teams proved costly as well last night too.
Yeah, no doubt about it, Kevin. Hi once again. And
somebody.
Yeah, I mean, if you're Wayne Wilson or Dave Insolaco, Brian Hills, there's nothing left to be said. Somebody in that dressing room has to stand up right now.
Yeah, you're way past big speech time. It's now, even seeing Dave Insolaco earlier tonight, I said, what do you think? He goes, hey, players got to play. So I think they're beyond, you know, driving home points, and this is what we got to do. It's up to the players. It's that Tigers pride, and it has to come through tonight.
As we take a look at our players to watch tonight, well, Walter Zacher had 2 last night. He's up to 9 on the season, but gosh, Klimke, Tanner Klimke last night, 4 points, John.
He was in on everything. He had a goal and 3 assists. They had a lot of players active. This is what they do. It's balanced scoring, as you mentioned. Klimke had a sensational night last night for the Colonials. If they're going to get another 3 points, it was brought to our attention that we did proclaim maybe RIT could get 9 points on our Tuesday night broadcast. We're just lucky to get 3 tonight.
Yeah, well, that's what's up for grabs here for the Tigers. Secondary scoring has been an issue. Certainly that line with Fukasa, Wild, and Catalano is doing something. But you take a look at the second line. Team captain or player to watch tonight, Tanner Andrew.
Hey, Tanner Andrew, 4 goals, 5 assists this year, but he is in a big-time slump. And if they're going to pull themselves out of it, they got to start getting more pucks to the net, getting more goals, scoring first. Starts with your captain. We talk about leaders stepping up. We're talking about the primetime players coming up big. It starts with the captain. Andrew needs a big night tonight.
And John, how important is it just to get the win? Because you have all this time off now. They're not on the ice until December 29th.
Yeah, Wayne even said that. We were talking before our interview. He goes, listen, we're off. We don't have a conference game for a while. You got to go into the holidays feeling good about yourselves. And I think tonight, I would call it a must win. It's not, the season's not going to end. But to feel good about yourselves going into the holiday, getting 3 points, this is a must win.
Yeah, Kevin, it's good to have you on the broadcast tonight, buddy. Glad you're back with us.
Good to be back with you guys. Missed you guys.
Wait a minute. No Taylor Swift concert?
No.
Are you sure, buddy?
You know, I should be in Vancouver the way things are going here, but hopefully.
Swifty, Roche. Hey, I like it.
We're down bad right now, but we're coming back. Tonight, get those 3 points.
All
thanks,
right,
guys. Appreciate it. Well, he's one of the most integral parts of the RIT hockey program, but his shifts on the ice don't determine whether the Tigers win or lose. His contributions certainly haven't gone unnoticed over the years, but his recent absence certainly has. Ice operations manager Stu Hughes was diagnosed with cancer earlier this fall, so tonight we'll share how you can help in his fight. But first, we take a look back at how Stu landed one of the coolest jobs on campus.
Stu Hughes has worked at RIT for over 4 decades, spending his first 20 years in facilities management before finding arguably the coolest job on campus.
I saw it listed and I thought it would be a unique job, something a little different. I was getting kind of tired of plowing snow, so I figured I'd go cut some snow instead. Yeah, I wanna drive the Zamboni.
Yeah, I wanna
it's a pretty fun job. Yeah, I've been very fortunate with my bosses that I've had throughout the years, that they've given me the tools I needed to, do a good job.
It's a job that can't be done alone. Hughes works with three other full-time staff members and employs nearly 15 students.
It's actually a lot of work. It can be very technical as far as people think, yeah, you just go out and lay water. There's a lot more to it than that. So there are some challenges, which makes it, for me, makes it fun.
Hughes can be described as meticulous when it comes to ice maintenance. The boards are clean, the glass is spotless, and the ice is as good as it gets.
I just like coming in and making sure that everything is in its place, the teams are ready to go, they have the best quality ice I can give them. I just enjoy that. I guess that was instilled in me when I was young. Whatever you do, and I tell my students this, I don't care if you're emptying garbage, whatever you do, just take pride in what you do. Do your best at whatever you're doing.
Yeah, Stu certainly has taken pride in his tremendous work here at RIT. As I mentioned earlier, Stu unable to be with us after recently being diagnosed with cancer. So many RIT fans, alums, the corner crew, the community as a whole has rallied behind him since his diagnosis. And you can help Stu in his fight, too, by visiting GoFundMe.com and search Stu Hughes. We know his daughter Amanda and, of course, Stu and his entire family appreciate all of your support. And, of course, we're wishing Stu all the best here from the RIT Sports Network. Well, we're closing in on Faceoff as we're now less than 10 minutes away. We'll wrap things up from here next. You're watching Pregame Live on the RIT Sports Network. Back here on Pregame Live, hard to believe RIT winless in Rochester this season. 0-7 tonight. They'll look to break that streak against Robert Morris. After tonight, the Tigers will return in 22 days at Bowling Green. They'll also host an exhibition against Guelph here on January 4th. However, the next home game that counts isn't until Friday, January 24th, when Niagara comes to town for the start of a two-game series. Our coverage begins that night, 6:30, with Pregame Live, followed by Faceoff 7:05, January 24th, exclusively on Flow Hockey. RIT will be home a lot in the new year, especially down the stretch. 8 of their final 10 games right here at the Coliseum. RIT hockey tickets make a great holiday gift, too. Get them for all the Tiger fans in your life by visiting or calling the box office or online right now, RITtickets.com. Well, that'll do it for Pregame Live. Up next, can the Tigers head into the holiday break on a positive? John and Gene will have all the action for you, and I'll see you back here for the intermission report. Until then, enjoy the game. RIT Robert Morris is next here on the RIT Sports Network.